Yo, what's poppin', everybody? It is your boy Christo back again with some more Xenoblade Chronicles X. Last time we finally got into NLA proper. We spoke with Secretary Nagi about Blade, and we have been instructed to just simply take a tour of the Administrator District. So that is what we're gonna be doing today.
You know, it's not every day we're authorized to let a civilian tour the administrative district.
Yeah. Nagi must really, really want him to join Blade.
The AD is a bit different from the other districts. It's got everything a Blade would need, all in one place, without any extra fluff.
Get a load of that skill! Even the way that they walk is so cool! Oh yeah, work it, baby! What? You don't remember what a skell is? That gorgeous exoskeleton that just went by? Basically like the most incredible, awesomest super weapons ever? Lasers, force fields, bipedal, and vehicular transformations. Sorry, I get so excited whenever I think about it.
Originally, skells were developed as a defensive measure to counter potential alien threats. It wasn't enough to save Earth, though. We were outnumbered and outgunned. Still, just look around you. New LA has gone from basically nothing to this in just 2 short months. We could never have come so far, so fast, without Skell technology. I'd love to get you into one to see for yourself, but it's not that simple.
Well, yeah, duh. For one thing, only Blades are allowed to pilot Skells. And even then, you need a license.
These aren't toys we're talking about. They're complex machines with powerful weapons. And they're a precious resource. We only have so many of them to go around. So yes, as you might imagine, the certification process is a fairly rigorous one.
I'm sure you're thinking, where do I sign up for the test? But it's not that simple. They choose you, not the other way around. You can't just walk in the front door and volunteer.
There is some criteria. The details are largely hidden, but basically, HQ only allows the cream of the crop to take the test. Blades who go above and beyond in their duties, and for the people of New LA in general.
So what do you say? If you become a Blade and work hard, I'm sure it'll only be a matter of time before they tap you on the shoulder.
Speaking of work, that reminds me. Why don't we check out the Mission Control Board first? That's where we take on our assignments.
Good call. Let's head on over.
All right. Yeah, it's always cool learning about the skills and everything, but yeah, this is gonna be just a quick run through of the administrative district, just to get all the essentials down.
So this is Mission Control. We don't have a dispatch system yet, so Blades usually choose their own assignments. Everyone comes here and selects from the missions available on the board.
And it's not just official Blade tasks. Anyone with a request is free to post here. Businesses, citizens, whoever.
Yeah, it's basically how anything gets done in New LA, so the board is constantly updating. Just about every Blade will stop by here at some point in their shift.
It's like our second home. You'll always find a number of Blades around here, blowing off steam or browsing Mission Control for their next assignment.
Whenever I get freed up, I'll stop here first thing to check for any missions I might be suited for.
Likewise. And if the assignment seems too tough to handle solo, that's what the Scout Console is for. We should show you that next.
Hey, who's giving this tour anyway? We also have the Scout Console. If the assignment seems too tough to handle solo. And Elma just said that, didn't she?
Hey.
Alright, so just to give a little bit more info, This mission control console, it's basically a... In Xenoblade Chronicles 1, there would be like people that would give like generic quests where it would be like, where it would say something like, you know, quest title 1, 2, 3, 4, that kind of stuff. And it would just be like, you know, collect this many of this item, kill this many of this generic monster. The Blade console basically, or the mission control basically fills that role. So you can just pick and choose what you want. Moving on, this is actually a feature that you can no longer use as far as I'm aware.
Ta-da! The Blade Scout Console. When the going gets tough, the tough go to the Scout Console. You know, to get tougher.
If you do end up joining us, you'll quickly realize just how important this little kiosk is. A lot of the mission control assignments are too much for any one Blade to handle. They tend to call for multiple members with specialized knowledge or unique skills. This console lets you search for and recruit other Blades to fill those roles for just such an occasion.
You can't spell Blade without team. Sort of. Anyway, awesome, right? So, you're ready to join up?
Hang on, Lynn. Take it easy, would you?
What? I'm just saying, you'd have to be some kind of an idiot not to want to join Blade. Or maybe a crazy person.
Oh, and here I thought you might be pressuring our guest.
Apology accepted. Now, how about a little shopping? And I'm not talking about the stuff over in the commercial district. I'm talking about Armory Alley.
Alright, so essentially what the Blade this Blade console does is that Wii U Online was shut down, you were actually able to upload your Blade to the game, so that way other people would be able to download it and have as a fourth part, or as a party member for a limited time. So it would be good to, for like, you know, if you're struggling with the game, you can come here, recruit someone a little bit higher leveled, and then get through a little bit easier. Like I said, as far as I'm aware, you can no longer use this because Wii U Online was shut down. So yeah, it is just one of those lost things that I'll absolutely be talking about later on. But Armory Alley is up next, just as Lynn said. Trust me, you're gonna learn also that the running and jumping is your best friend here.
So this street's what we call Armory Alley.
Blades can requisition equipment from any of the vendors here.
I won't lie, most Blade members face danger on a daily basis. Having the latest gear isn't about impressing your friends. It's a matter of survival.
True enough. And that goes not only for your personal armor and weapons, what we call ground gear, but for Skell equipment as well.
You can even buy whole Skells. Can you imagine owning your own Skell?
I'd imagine it's like owning your own car.
Right, the tour. I think all that's left is the heart of Blade itself. Blade Tower.
Alright, so basically this yellow console is where you can buy new stuff with the credits that you get. And over here, at the arms manufacturers, you can essentially fund, you know, the people in game making the weapons, so that way there'll be more options, they'll be stronger, and you can also like even forge entirely new stuff with materials to drop from monsters, which is really neat. And moving along further down Armory Alley. And up to Blade Tower.
So yeah, Blade Tower. When we come here, it's usually to stop by Blade HQ. The higher-ups, like Secretary Nagi and Commander Vandam, will spend most of their day here. The government leaders, too. They're based in the tower. Guys like our new Director General Maurice Chausson, for example.
Blades sometimes report to the leadership here after we finish key assignments. You'll want to remember this place.
I mean, it's not like you can miss it. I mean, it's a massive tower.
Amazing setup, right? You can't wait to join Blade, right?
Okay, Lynn, seriously, that's enough. We're not here to make a sales pitch. We just want you to have all the facts so you can make an informed decision to join us, or not. Now that you've seen where and how we work, hopefully it made a good impression, but your decision will be just that, your decision. In any case, let's head back to the barracks. Secretary Nagi will be waiting.
All right. And with that, chapter one is actually completed. I will save.
Well, ain't that a kick in the pants?
Yes, and from completing quests and stuff, you do get experience, just like in the other games. There's another alley here, even though there's nothing really down here. Just another way to get from point A to point B if you need to. And we head into the barracks.
Honey, we're home.
Yes, very amusing.
Who wants a fresh cup of tea?
Thank you, Ms. Gu, but I can't stay long. I just wanted to pass along a request from your commanding officer.
Commander Vandam? Does it have anything to do with our new arrival?
Correct. He stopped by while you were out on your tour. He said he'll come back, but that I shouldn't wait to ask you.
Here we go. I bet I can guess.
You probably can. He wants to fast-track our new friend here for blade duty with a training assignment.
What in the hell are we waiting for?
As he put it.
The commander does have a way with words.
Makes even my pitch sound smooth.
I explained about the memory issues, but he didn't see it as a problem. And to be honest, given our current need for blade recruits, I can't say I entirely disagree.
Hey, it's not me you need to convince. Blade service is voluntary, remember?
Of course, and I would never force or coerce anyone.
Well, friend, what do you say? Can we count on you to do your part?
I knew you'd make the right choice. Welcome to the organization. Elma, he can start on your team. You'll begin training immediately.
Yes, Mr. Secretary. With pleasure.
All right. Welcome to the Cool Kids Club.
Now then, let's discuss that training assignment.
All right, let's hear him out.
We've decided to start you out on a probe installation, just to get your feet wet.
I guess we should back up a bit. Here in New LA, we're using a specialized computer system called FrontierNav to help us deploy a sensor grid across Mira. A network of data probes that allows us to monitor conditions and collect all kinds of information about the planet.
Expanding that grid and filling in the blind spots is one of Blade's highest priorities. Here. Take a look at this. What you're seeing on screen is a terrain map that includes New LA and the surrounding landmass. As you can see, we've divided the area into a series of hexagonal blocks. We call these blocks segments. Together, they form our grid.
Man, I'm so glad that there are subtitles, because this definitely is a game where the music definitely overpowers the dialogue.
The FrontierNav probes can also detect the general locations of living things in the vicinity, which comes in handy if we need to track down a Blade or another citizen.
Yes, quite handy indeed. So for this first exercise, you'll be heading here, to that white segment. Go there, install the data probe, and then come back home.
Got it, east of the city.
In that case, we can take the East Gate out of the Administrative District, right? We should be there in no time.
I'll leave the details on the data probe installation procedure to you, Wilma.
Of course, Mr. Secretary. All right, you two, shall we?
Yeah! Training or not, let's go install the hell out of that probe!
All right, Chapter 2 begins. We need to head to the designated site in the East Gate Plain. Chapter 2, The New Frontier. Alright. And, just like before, we need to head out of the barracks.
Man, am I glad we pulled an assignment to the east of the city this time. It'd be a long walk all the way back over to the West Gate.
Hold on. Are we even sure the East Gate will be open? Last I heard, it was still on lockdown from all the high-level indigen activity.
It was, but they just lowered the threat level earlier today. The gates are officially open for business. One of our teams must have gone out there and kicked some furry indigen butt, huh?
Wouldn't surprise me at all. Irina's team is one of our best.
How does he know Irina and Gwyn?
We ran into them just before we met up with you. They were on their way out to an assignment.
Well, then that settles it. It must have been them, right? Man, forget this amateur hour probe baloney. Those guys are where the action's at.
I'll try not to take that personally. But enough talk. We've got our mission to deal with. Let's head out.
Roger. That probe isn't gonna install itself. Let's get to the East Gate, shall we?
Alright. Yes, there is a map on the Wii U gamepad. That's what handles like all fast travel and stuff, but until I can figure out a good way to record the Wii U gamepad, I don't know how I'm going to show that off. But just because I know what's coming next, I am going to come here and we are going to go ahead and call this a day. Thank you all so much for watching. If you enjoyed, you all know what to do. Have yourselves a damn good one. Later.